Hi, welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. Today I want to talk to you about the Big Bang and the cosmic microwave background radiation. But before I do so, I'll revise something that we talked about already, the expansion of the universe. And if you feel like this is not enough, then you can go back and check that video before you come back to this one. So if you look at this first slide that I have here, it's a beautiful picture taken by the Hubble Space Telescope that shows many galaxies. Almost everything you see in this picture is a galaxy, with the exception of a couple stars here. Everything else is a galaxy. And here, I chose three galaxies that look very similar. They look like face-on spirals. And if you notice, some of them, the blue one appears bigger, and the red one appears smaller. So it's pretty clear that the red one is probably further away from us than the blue one, assuming that they all have the same size. What Hubble noticed is that galaxies that are further away from us, like the red one, are moving away from us at fast speeds, while galaxies that are closer to us are also moving away from us, but at slower speeds. And that is independent of the direction in the sky that you look at. So Hubble measured distances to galaxies and velocities, and the galaxy's velocity with respect to us, and plotted this very famous diagram, which is called the Hubble diagram or Hubble law, showing that on average, the recessional velocities of galaxies increase as they are further and further away from us. This is evidence for the expansion of the universe. If you think about it, if the universe is expanding, it was smaller in the past. Being smaller in the past is evidence that there was a time when the universe started, a time of the beginning of the universe, a Big Bang time. So the expansion of the universe is direct evidence for the Big Bang. And using this evidence and many others that I won't go in detail here, we can determine the history of the universe. So if we look at this other slide that we have here, now the universe is full of galaxies up here. The universe is full of galaxies. And in the past, well, the galaxies weren't very formed yet. And as the universe was younger and younger and younger, it was hotter and hotter and denser. So I'll go very briefly to these phases, and then I'll talk to you about the cosmic microwave background radiation. So the very first era is what we call the Planck era. Before the Planck time of 10 to the minus 43 seconds, we don't know anything. So we can't say anything about the universe before that time. But this is a pretty small time, and we can say a lot since then. So after the Planck era, there are a couple other eras that I will skip, but I'll just mention the Gut era and the Lettre-Week era. You can go in more detail some other time. And then particle era, that's when protons start to form. All the matter and antimatter annihilate, and when we start to have particles form. After that, as the universe cools down more, the nuclei start to combine into atoms. So this is what we call the era of nucleosynthesis. It's a very small era, a very important era, because that's when protons and neutrons combine together to start to form atoms. And after that, we continue to form elements, but it's still very hot and very dense in this environment. The universe continues to cool down, and until an age of 380,000 years, the universe is so hot and so dense that no atom stays stable. The atoms break apart and become fundamental particles again. At this time, light that it's emitted because the particles are moving around is trapped. It can't escape. We say that at this time the universe was opaque. there were particles, they were forming atoms, and then they were breaking apart again because it was so hot and so dense. But the photons couldn't travel much because the density was so high that they were trapped to interact with something else. It's only after this time, at about 380,000 years, that atoms, that the universe is cool enough that the atoms form and remain as atoms. That allows the photons then to escape. They are not trapped anymore. And those photons we can observe because they escape that era. After that, there is the era of galaxies that we live in, today, from an age of 1 billion years up to today. So let's keep this in mind and go back to that image. The three galaxies, one further away, one at average distance, one closer to us. I can represent them as three objects that I believe to be very similar. Three candles that I believe to be the same. Well, the furthest one appears smaller because it's further away from us. The closest one appears bigger. But there is more to that here. If we think about it, the light that left this red galaxy here must have left the galaxy a very long time ago. Because the galaxy is so far away from us, the light has been traveling for a very long time until we receive it. The galaxy close to us, well, the light maybe left just a billion years ago or so, and it's already reaching us. So what really happens is that we see those galaxies at different ages, at different stages of evolution. The galaxy that's the furthest away, we are seeing it as it was when it was a baby, when the universe was first formed. The galaxy that's close to us, the blue galaxy, has evolved a lot. The candle has burned. It's an older galaxy. And we see it now as more evolved. If we extrapolate this idea and we keep looking at things that are further and further away, we'll eventually get back to that special time of 380,000 years in the life of the universe, where the photons started to be free and move freely in space until they reach us today. So if we move back even more, we see a picture like this. This is the cosmic microwave background. It's a baby picture of the universe. It's the most distant picture that we can take because light from before this time wasn't able to reach us. It just scattered around and wasn't able to reach us. So if we observe the sky, not in an optical wavelength like we did for the beautiful picture of galaxies that I showed you, but if instead we observe it at a different wavelength, at the radio wavelength, then what we see is this baby picture of the universe where galaxies weren't formed yet, but you see that there's a little bit of structure starting to form. This little bit of structure that we see is what will become galaxies and clusters and so on. So I hope that helped you understand what the cosmic microwave background is. I suggest you also check my YouTube video on the expansion of the universe, which is very much relevant to this subject. And there is a free online textbook about astronomy that I highly recommend that you should also check. See you next time.